You are listening now to A Word of Faith with Bishop Macedo.
Thanks be to God, may the Spirit of the Most High, the Spirit of righteousness and justice, and pure, of what is clean and honest, of what is real and true, may the Spirit of the Most High be with you, my dear listener, right now, from today and always. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God, my dear listener. We read here on Psalms 112, it says like this. Look at what it's written, my dear listener. Look how wonderful. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who delights greatly in his commandments. Who delights greatly in his commandments. So you who are listening to me right now, and you have pleasure in the Most High, you are blessed. Blessed means happy. So happy are those that has great, who delights greatly in his commandments, because the commandments of Most High is righteous, disciplined, is discipline of order. And who likes to have a family that is upside down? You know, when I got married, for instance, I wanted to have a fixed home, a family that is together. Because when I was single, I was upside down. I had no harmony, no, I had no one to be worried. So I needed somebody who would build a family together with me, so that my life then could be organized. So, when we got married, we began to seek harmony. When we got married, not only to just because we loved one another, but we got married thinking about tomorrow, thinking on giving our children discipline, order. So, my dear listener, this is what it is to be righteous. We get married because we love righteousness. In the end, we want to organize our life. All people that likes order and discipline, likes to be organized, these people, they love righteousness. And consequently, they love God's commandments. They take pleasure in His commandments because God's commandments, they are to discipline the human being. It's God's commandments that teaches us not to rob, not to kill, not to commit adultery, not to betray, not to accuse or give false accusations. It's God's commandments that makes us to have discipline in life according to God, that makes us to walk in the light, that makes us to walk in the light and consequently have peace. But when we rebel against God's word, then becomes what society has been. You know, society has been upside down. You know, people do crazy things that promote horrible things of making children to touch naked people's body, you know, doing these crazy things and promoting these things, it's not wise. And I want to know if it was their daughter, if their child, their own child, would do such a thing with adults. A 5-year-old or 4-year-old would touch or lay hands on a man. But they promote these kind of things because they love to do what is bad. And they do it to other people, not their own. So, my dear listener, we praise God because we are able to receive from God. We have received from the Most High this conscience of order and discipline, living in harmony, of peace. We have peace within our homes. We have peace, not confusion, no conflict in us, but we obey God's word. And the word of God says more, His offspring shall be mighty in the land. So our offspring, our descendants, and our children's children, they are going to be blessed. They are going to be powerful, mighty in the land. And it says more, the generation of the upright, meaning the righteous, shall be blessed. Wealth and riches shall be in his house, and his righteousness endures forever. This psalm is very beautiful. Psalms 112 is good for you to meditate, and says more what is written here on Psalms 112, verse 7 says, he shall not be afraid of evil. His heart is fixed, trusting in the Lord. So when a person walks, when they walk in God's word, when they fear God, when they obey God's word, they are not afraid of rumors. They are not afraid of gossips. They are not afraid of bad mouth, people that bad mouth, because their heart is fixed, trusting in God. And the hardest thing is for you to be anxious or for you to be upset because of somebody's gossip, right? How many people they become upset when they hear somebody's gossip, and they even sometimes driving and get the knowledge of what the rumors, they even get into accidents because they heard what people are commenting about them, what people are talking bad about them, sometimes even a false information. But those that fear the Lord, they are not afraid of the rumors because their heart is fixed upon the Lord. And it says more, his heart is established. He shall not be afraid until he sees triumph upon his enemies. And there is more. Verse 10 says, The wicked shall see it and be grieved. In other words, the wicked will see the just and will become grieved. That's why you see people envying, manifesting anger against people, because they live in hell. They live in a living hell in their home. You know, each one is there. Is going about their own business. There is no unity. In fact, they do not have a home. They all lived by themselves, locked up in their own room. And why so? Because they are wicked. There is no order. They live in a disorder, disorderly manner. They like filthiness, dirtiness. So it's people who are wicked. And this is how God sees them. So the wicked shall see the righteous, so then they become grieved. They, it says here, he shall gnash his teeth and melt away. In other words, they become angry. The wicked's desire will fall. The desire of the wicked shall perish. So the wicked has desires, they have vision, but they will never conquer. They will never see it coming through in their lives, because they are wicked. They live causing evil. They live in injustice, going against the Lord Almighty. They go against the one who is just and righteous, who is clean, what is right. They go against the God who is holy, and he who is holy of holies. So these people, they melt away day by day. And there is more. They gnash their teeth in anger, with hatred, because the more the righteous grow, more the wicked grows down, more they become angry. They have a very bitterness, anger within them, because all the curse, all the talks they have, all the gossip that they do, all the bad rumors they make and create, has no success. And that's why they melt away and perish. So, my dear listener, how great it is for us to love and to follow and to be together with the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Israel. How glorious it is for us to have Jesus as our only Lord and Savior, our only God, living God, who is powerful, and that answers our prayers, that hears our prayers, and he does according to his will, according to his time, not according to our own desires and wishes, our selfish way, but according to his way. The Lord Jesus, our Lord, he gives us direction, he gives us guidance, he gives us life, he gives us understanding, he gives us the conscience, and he also gives us what is right. He organizes our life. He was the one who created and formed family. And the family, once is built upon God's word, this family is happy. That's why it's written in Psalms, "Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. For he shall eat the fruit of the labor, and he'll be happy, and everything will be well with him. His wife will be like a fruitful vine, and your house and your children like olive shoots around your table." So the man who fears the Lord is happy on the earth. You who are listening to me right now, my dear listener, and you desire to be happy, Take a Bible. Take the Holy Scripture and begin to read it. The Holy Spirit will speak with you. Maybe at first you may not understand. It's even natural. But what you need to understand, what God wants to tell you, He will tell you. He will make you to understand. Read this Bible. Bishop, what is the scripture I should read? You should start reading the Bible from the Old Testament and the New Testament. For example, you read the first chapter of Genesis, and then you read Matthew chapter 1 of the New Testament. And consecutively, you read a chapter day at a time. And what God wants you to understand, what God wants to tell you, you will know when you read His Word. Amen? So, get yourself a Bible. You are going to read it, and the Holy Spirit will direct you. Do this, and you are investing in your spiritual life. You are going to be investing in God's kingdom, and consequently, you are going to be blessed. Thanks be to God.
Yuquan is now an honest man with a promising future. But in the past, he was a drug dealer who was always fearing for his life.
Very, very depressed. I was almost killed many times, basically rock bottom. To my mother, I was a reproach. I was suicidal. When we would smoke a lot, we would use drugs. My life was terrible. I was a drug dealer, womanizer, gangbanger. I would have guns hidden in my house without my mother knowing. When my mother discovered everything, she was hurt. She felt she was to blame for me being the way I was, but it wasn't her. I basically did everything she raised me not to do. But because I didn't have my father around and because of the area which I lived, it was easy for me to become the element of my neighborhood.
I didn't raise
Mom,
you
it's
to
not
do
your fault.
This!
It's just a good job, an easy way to make money.
A good job? It's dangerous. This hurts people. You are acting just like the devil.
For about a year and a half, I lived out of the house of my mother because I moved out because things were getting too crazy. There were people circling our area where we live looking for me. So I moved with a friend. And then at one point in my life, I was house hopping.
I don't know where else to go. I told you, you can stay here as long as you want.
I had people looking for me to kill me. I owed a lot of people money. There was a lot of problems in my life. So my life at that point, I was at basically rock bottom. The worst moment of my life was actually when I lost one of my best friends to the drug game. He was selling drugs and someone from a rival gang, they killed him. But at that moment, it felt like, even though it wasn't me that died, it felt like a part of me died. Because that was one of my closest friends.
Take me for a pool. It's all there. Count it.
The hardest time for me actually was when a gun was pulled in my face and they actually pulled the trigger. And at that moment, I thought I was gonna die. I thought everything was over. And they shot right by my head, but they missed. My mother, she just had a nervous breakdown because of many negative things I was doing.
It was his mother who pushed him to look for help.
Well, then I know a place you can go. They can really help you. A friend of mine recommended it to me.
I'll go.
And at that moment, I knew I had no choice but to turn to God.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains.
To my surprise, when I arrived in the church, nobody judged me. Everybody, they looked to me and said, hey, how are you doing, my friend? Hey, come, you can sit here. Hey, the service is about to start. People were actually speaking to me. So it surprised me. After the service, I felt even better because I was able to pour out everything to God. To the listeners, I would advise, never doubt God. Because even me, I doubted God. But when I started to truly trust in Him, He changed my life. So if you are there doubting Him, if you are there thinking He's not real, change your mindset. When I changed my mindset, I was able to see a change in my life.
I haven't seen you look this peaceful in a long time.
I haven't felt this peaceful in a long time.
When I finally stopped suffering, I felt great. I felt like a brand new person. It was a relief. It was something I thought would never happen in my life. I said, wow, only God can make a difference in my life.
This world has strained, and it seems to have no end. Every dream you had has gone without a trace, and you've tried to find your place, but found disgrace. Illusions turned to stone, and tears appeared to fall.
there's still one thing left to do. It all depends on you. It can turn the old and make it new. It all depends on you. Take a look at what you're going through, but still he cares for you. Surrender all to him and you will see. Oh. It all depends on you. He can change your life and take you high. It all depends on you. He can bring the sun back to your sky, and still he'll care for you. All you have to do is trust your life in him. For you, all you have to do is trust your life.